Luke in Orlando, Florida. I'm here with Mike and Mark from No Bragging Rights. How you guys doing?
Good.
Good, man.
Good, man. How are you?
Pretty good.
Good. You guys are about a week and a half here tour with Running Out.
Yeah.
How's been treating you?
It's been good, man. We don't know what to expect from the tour. You know, it's a very, it's, I don't know. Yeah, it's been cool. It's a mixed bill, but it's a cool bill.
Yeah.
It was really cool, and the show's been really cool, and the stuff is great.
How's the crowd reaction overall been for you guys?
It's been hit or miss, honestly. I mean, like, in some markets, we just don't do well in some markets we do. I mean, especially with a tour like this, you know? Like,
yeah.
We're not,
I like to pick apart for a band play.
So, like, a lot of bands, we have to see, like, the beautiful walls and riding out, like,
I remember seeing you guys here in the Straight from the Bath. I mean, is it slightly different because Running Out has such a cult following, and on the Straight from the Bath tours, like, I noticed that the crowd reaction to Straight from the Bath tour was a lot better, actually. But for you guys, but that was a more evened out bill.
Yeah, I mean, you know, that tour backup was like,
yeah. Oh, I mean, yeah, I mean, straight
straight backup in, like, you know, it was a cool tour backup, and I feel like a lot of kids overall,
yeah,
listen to more of those bands overall,
yeah,
than, you know, than they would with this tour backup, which is why I feel it was that way, you know. But I mean, even tonight,
I thought the reaction was pretty good,
but still, I thought it was good as hell, so.
I think it's just a lot of these, a lot of the Right Out fans are seeing us for the first time. So that's awesome.
It was that way actually when I saw them open the store so far back in November. It was funny because there were so many people there that were just like asking me, oh, does this band sound like the store so far? I'm just like, But alright, so your latest full length cycle, it's been out for about a year and a half now. Is there any update? Like, are you working on new music currently? Or?
Yeah. After this tour, we have like 7 new songs, so we're gonna write the album. We have ideas here and there, but nothing structured. No like full songs together. But we start recording May 15th, so after this tour, we're just gonna stay home and just put it all together and get in there and do the damn thing.
Do you think that the album will come out like late this year? Or?
Hopefully by the fall.
Yeah.
Yeah, the goal is to have it out by the fall. So yeah.
All right, for people that aren't familiar with,
this is our friend. What's your name?
So anyways, for people that haven't heard Cycles, can you talk about the lyrics in this video?
We have ranges from a conversation with my dad, just about the idea of you know, you weren't given the opportunity to, I guess, let's go over this about my dad. My dad was abused as a child, so he didn't want to have kids, but looking at my mom, talking to me to, you know, realize that, you know, he wasn't his dad, he wasn't, you know, what his dad raised him up to be, I guess. And you know, my dad made a choice to not be like his father, and which was an abusive alcoholic. And you know, he chose to be opposite of that. I mean, awesome dad, raised me differently. You know, he was a great dad, even though he never had one. Hope Theory is about not losing. Hope Theory is basically like trying to hang in there, even though people are constantly telling you that like life should get better. Because I'm not personally a lot of people. I'm just constantly encouraging people, and every now and then, believe me, it's like, you know, hey man, it's not getting better for me. And have to stay on it, because I really do believe that you work hard and you make it. Yeah, you know, things can change. Like, you know, seeing it in my father's life, I saw it at home. We've seen it with friends, you know, in bands, on tour, at home, and family members. Like, it happens, and it doesn't happen overnight. It's a slow process. And that's what growth theory basically are. It's a process, so it takes time. But it eventually, like, things will eventually look up, you know? The ideas just change, you know, like you have the opportunity to change things. You have the opportunity to keep things going, get something good in your life, you have the opportunity to keep that going, you have the opportunity to pass that on to someone else.
I asked you this last time, but I mean the answer could change. Great to be, what's the best concert you've ever played?
I still probably got it at the Glass House in 2001. That's what I said.
I didn't play.
I think last time you said something about Slayer.
It was Kill Switch. It was Kill Switch Engage, Lamb of God, Dr. Bear.
That's it.
And then Headbangers Ball Tour 2002. Within These Walls Fest 2012 in Arizona, that was cool too. I saw a lot of bands for the first time that I didn't see, including the beautiful ones, like the COVID first time seeing them, and then the
bands.
Youth F2 Day, H2O. That was really cool.
What are some of your favorite music releases from the past year? Or anything that's coming out that you're saying?
2015.
Either that or just sometimes you're not too good. Or anything that you're excited about.
Well, that was Black Beautiful. It was like still probably one of the favorites from 2015.
For me, the most recent Drake album was really good for me. Recent Justin Timberlake record was really good. Like, I played both all the fucking times. So, like, it's not listening to.
I'm excited to hear you guys from the album. We're done with
New Stig, New Comeback Kid.
Has it been released?
No, not yet.
It's streaming everywhere.
Yeah. I heard one song.
I'm actually interviewing the whole music.
Oh, cool. Yeah.
Tell them. Very cool.
Backtrack, it's all but down for us.
Yeah, not that good.
It's ridiculous. Yeah. Alright, what's the one band that you wish you could tour with or that you have here?
Tour with like realistically or like?
It's like a band that's still together.
Stick to your guts.
Yeah, it was on those.
Never told them?
No, never told them. We played shows and I never told them. So then, Come Back Kid.
Come Back Kid.
Take a set on tour, yeah? I don't know. I'd say those are like the two main ones for me.
Now, do you, what is No Bragging Rights mean to you personally?
It's my life. I've been knowing it since I was 15. What's nice is that I enjoy the music. I enjoy playing the music, doing shows, and you know, it's a little harder now. But what I like about it, what keeps it fresh for us, and I feel like our music is going beyond it's a style that someone likes versus people are getting something out of our music. That's great. From LA, I had a bad day and I couldn't walk. That's awesome. That's great. It's the message that's taking over
that world. Are there any plans that never wanted to
I would issue Consequence of Dreams. Anything else, I don't know.
Yeah, anything before that.
Yeah, I can't find it anywhere.
Yeah, that's alright, man.
You told me you didn't really care for it?
No. For what we were at that time,
yeah.
Like, it was cool.
It was cool. It was the first record I recorded in the band.
Yeah.
I joined in 2005.
Yeah.
And so, but like, I feel like, it's like not the same band anymore. I mean, yeah, it's just not the same band.
Now, is from what I know, No Bragging Rights is actually on its 15th year anniversary.
The name.
You did something?
No, I did.
You did as well, thought. But I mean, you started in 99. Yeah, so yeah, it's been 15 years. Like, are you, planning on doing anything related at all?
I don't want to do it with my parents. Maybe we'll do something online.
I feel like, let's be honest, from back when Mike started it,
yeah.
So when we actually started touring, it's like two different.
I want it, I'd be cool to, I guess, give it some recognition for what it is.
Yeah.
It started in 99. The name's around 99. But, I feel like the band now, the writers now, that came about in 2005. So that's like, to me, that's kind of like, that's like the second wave. Whereas before that, It was more punk rock, and that was typical California garage band.
Yeah.
My buddy was in the jam, we played it good, we had fun, it's even advanced, and I'm very proud of the 1999 to 2004, for NBR, and I'm also very proud of 2005 to now. So it's a different dance.
Alright, well, thanks for taking the time to talk to us. Is there anything you'd like to tell anybody that's ever supported the records?
Thank you. Again, thank you for giving us a chance. We hope to have a new record out by the end of the year, so for that. And say what's up. Yeah, talk to us at the show. Say what's up. Talk to us and our friends, because we don't have any. Just kidding. No, we don't. I guess that's it, yeah.